If you're in the market for a brand new laser engraver that can have infrared, diode, is fully enclosed and very safe, you might be interested in the Sculpfun iCube Ultra. My name's Chris, this is L3D Accessories, and I will be fully reviewing this and testing a full range of materials. So if you're interested, stay tuned and let's get straight to it. Let's run through the specification. So the price at starting point is $349 early bird price. That's for the standard version with one laser module, $549 for the dual version, and you can see the various different sizes, 150 by 150 millimeter engraving area on the diode version. Lots of different materials. This machine is really safe, fully enclosed, temperature sensor, security key, safety doors, and also an autofocus function, which is great. The working area is bigger than its rival lasers, which is a big selling point, and it has a high-speed engraving motherboard up to 10,000 millimeters a minute. And finally, there is an extension slide and a rotary tool available if you're also interested in buying that. With the unboxing, you can see it comes in one box, really simple. It's well packaged, very well protected, but at the same time, it's such a quick and easy experience to get it out the box and set up. Everything is housed within the packaging, and it comes with a nice tool set there, power supply brick, and I got the UK plug. We also have safety glasses, which is always great when they're included, the USB transfer cable, two pieces of material, and then you've got the extraction hose, laser repair kit, and our two laser modules, because remember, we have the dual one in this case. We have an infrared laser module and we have a diode laser module. And you'll see now everything laid out on the desk. That is the total amount of things that come with this machine. Usually the assembly sections have got quite a bit of assembly, but for this one, it's so simple. We put the fan outlet on the back, four screws, as simple as that. We're taking the build plate off. It's held in with two screws, I'm guessing for transit. And we need to do that because the way we install the laser module is by turning the machine on its side, as you can see right here. You then offer up the laser up onto the rails through the side. Use the two thumb screws in there to secure it in place. And as you can see, this is really simple to do. Then you have your power cable, which you just push in there. A Molex style connector, really easy. Build plate back on. Then we're gonna adjust it to approximately the right height. And the great thing about this laser is everything is just so simple. I mean, you saw the power on the side. It's such a simple IO. You've got the off on switch, you've got a USB port, you've got a USB-C port. Those are obviously for the accessories you can get. There are two buttons on the side. One of them is a self-leveling button. The other is a start, stop, kind of resume button. All simple, as you can see. Then on the rear, we have our exhaust outlet. I love the fact this thing has an exhaust and a filter. Then you've got your USB security token, so you can't run it without that in, which is a great thing. It's a laser of class one safety specification. I always like it when you have an emergency off button, because when you get caught in sticky situations, sometimes you can't think straight, so whacking a button is perfect. This is a great feature. So the front cover can be opened like a door, which is great if you want to quickly adjust, but if you're using the infrared laser, you can actually take the whole thing off, and assuming you wear your safety glasses, you don't need it on there. And I love that. As I said a minute ago, it has a fan built into it, so it literally filters out those toxins and helps eliminate the smell, which is brilliant. I love the removable base plate as well. Moving on to LightBurn setup. So I did use LightBurn for this, and there isn't a profile currently available to import in. So I got given instructions how to load in the settings myself. And you can see on the screen, this is the process you need to follow if you want to go down the same road. Put in all the settings as I've shown it here, and it will work absolutely fine. I do hope they have a profile set up in the near future, and I'm sure they will. But in the meantime, this should get you started and be good enough. Now, one thing this laser's got that a lot of other things don't have, a self-leveling capability, and that's a really great feature. And we're going to run an initial material test on a piece of wood here just to get our optimal settings before we actually do some of this material testing. As you can see, doing a really great job. Unfortunately, I didn't actually put the piece of wood down very well, so it did move during the process, so it got a little bit wonky. But you can see here the results will come in, and really nice clear engraving. So let's get on with the proper testing. now we're switching over to the infrared laser module, and we'll run some more tests and you can get a gist exactly what this thing can do. Now that we've seen all of the engraving, let's check out the results. This thing blew me away. That hip flask, the wood cutting, the leather keyrings, they were all so clean, all so crisp. The tees, it's a shame about my bad positioning, but they still look really good. The paper cutting was really good. The pen, once again, such a good engraving, so quick. The wood was really clear. The 3D prints is such a great opportunity to do things, and the picture of me, beautiful as always. I hope this gives you a good idea of what this thing is capable of. So there you have it. We have done a full range of testing and we have really pushed the Sculpfun iCube Ultra to its limits. And now, having done that, I've got some really, really good opinions on it, pros and cons, that I can give all of you. So let's start with the pros. So the first thing I love about this laser is I love that it is fully enclosed. I mean, you have a full 360 degree enclosure, which literally stops any light escaping. So if safety is your paramount concern, and it should be at the end of the day, then that is something that is a really, really good feature and something that really puts your peace of mind at bay. I also love that it has a removable base plate. Those of you that know me know I do a lot of laser engraving, and having a removable base plate, it does two things for you. One, it allows you to make jigs, which makes engraving so much more streamlined. And two, it means you can take the laser, put it on an object, and engrave straight through, which is also a really, really good benefit. The third thing I love is the dual laser setup. This is a thing that's coming in with all the lasers now. You've got an infrared laser module and you've got a diode laser module. And that literally, as you can see here, opens up your world to every type of material possible. And that is something that is a really good thing. And as I said, you see it more and more now. Another thing that I really love is the autofocus option. There's a button on the side of the unit, as I showed you in the review, and it means the laser comes down, it prods the surface of the item you're engraving, and then it literally auto aligns itself. And that is something you don't get in a lot of budget entry-level lasers. That's a really, really good thing that this thing offers. The other thing that you need to think of with a laser is the exhaust fumes. When you engrave things, you get smoke and you get soot and you get fine particles. This thing has a filter built into it and also an exhaust that pulls it out. And that is a really great feature, in my opinion. It's another thing you don't see in many of the lower level entry level lasers. And it's another thing that gives you peace of mind. And my final thing that I love about this is the actual design of it. I love how inside it's so simple. There's lots of open space for you to put your items in there. The removable door as well means that you can pop it off and you can really, really have a great engraving experience. The cable routing is really well done. It's really maintained, nothing's gonna get snagged. It's all really good in that sense. So now I'm gonna move on to the cons. And the first one, and this is something I think will be rectified in the coming months, is there isn't currently a LightBurn profile for this laser. I had to manually set it up. It was very easy to do. They provided instructions how to do it. However, for me personally, having a profile that you can just plug in and know that it's fully optimized for the laser is something that is really, really important. So that is something that I would look forward to seeing implemented into this laser in the near future. Another con is that when you turn it on, the fan just kicks in straight away. There isn't a button to turn the fan off, so it increases a constant droning noise in the background. It's a really quiet noise. It's something that if you've got 3D printers or other hardware, you know fans are just a thing that come with it. However, just adding that little feature in there to be able to turn it off or for it to automatically kick in or kick off during the engraving would be a really easy way to just excel this up to that next level. Another con for me, and I think this is probably just once again, the fact that it's a brand new laser and they're still implementing these aspects, it's to do with the internal lighting and the door shut off safety feature. So the lighting is, you know, it's good enough to see inside, but if you want to frame the item, you have to have the door closed because there is a magnetic sensor that when you close the door, it actually allows the laser to move. It's a really great safety feature, but what it means is, unless you've got full visibility into that laser, which you've got good visibility, I'm just saying you need to improve the lighting a little bit so that if you're gonna insist that the door has to be closed to do the framing, and once again, this might be something that you can turn off and that I didn't realize about, but if you wanna be able to do that, then you need to increase that internal lighting just a little bit so that you've got full, easy visibility inside of it. So my final con is an aesthetic con, and it's to do with the buttons on the side of the unit. They're really, really practical buttons, really great to have. I would like to see a little bit more labeling on there just for those who don't have that user manual in front of them. Self-leveling button has a little kind of imprinted logo on it, which kind of gives you an idea. But the other button, which is to pause it, to redo jobs, it doesn't have any kind of identifier on it. Adding something to it would just make it that little bit more beginner friendly and that little bit more user friendly. And it's an easy win. So Sculpfun, if you are watching this, I recommend you do that in future designs if you do it. So now for the final part. This is the bit you're waiting for. Would I recommend this laser engraver, the Sculpfun iCube Ultra? And the short answer is yes. To summarize why, the enclosure is great, the extraction out the back is great, the fact that you can have two types of lasers, the diode and the infrared, the fact that it is very safe, it's got built-in safety features, the fact that it's got the auto focus feature, the large build plate, the removable front cover, and also the removable base plate. All those things are massive things, and it's something you don't get with all of its rival competitors. The price point is great. This machine is perfect if you are looking to get into laser engraving, but also if you want to take your machine to trade shows or if you want to go out and try and do on-site engraving, it's also good for that because it's compact enough that you can carry with you. It's enclosed so that you'll meet those trade shows criteria for safety. And it's just a general overall really good laser, and I really enjoyed my experience with it. So I want to thank you guys again for watching. If you have enjoyed, please hit the subscribe button. I'm trying to grow the channel and you guys are so important for me to do that. Also, if you did like anything you saw in this video, leave a comment. Let me know your thoughts. I'm always looking to improve and I want to give you guys exactly what you need. Finally, I will say in the description, there is an affiliate link and there are some links to my social medias. Feel free to check them out. If you want to support the channel, I really, really do appreciate it. I hope you all enjoyed the review. I hope you took something from it. And as I said a minute ago, reach out to me if you have any questions and I will do my best to answer them for you. Thank you so much and have a lovely day, guys. Take it easy.